When we look at the world around us, we typically measure it in inches and centimeters, or miles and kilometers. But in the field of nanotechnology, we work in nanometers. That's 1/1,000,000,000th of a meter. If you take a dime and slice it on edge 1,000 times, take one of those pieces and slice it another 1,000 times, you now have one piece that's 1 nanometer thick. When you start looking at the world on a nano level, everything changes. At the IIN, we're not just imagining the future, we're building it 1 nanometer at a time. The IIN is the International Institute for Nanotechnology and is one of the largest, if not the largest, nanotech operation in the world that focuses on the pure aspects of nanoscience and technology.
Nanomaterials are really the building blocks of our world. Atoms and molecules assemble to form nanostructures, which ultimately make up the properties of the materials that we live with and that we work with.
Whether it's in clean energy, the development of medicines, the development of materials for food and water safety, the way we create major solutions to some of the biggest problems in the world is through nanotechnology. The problems that we're going after, they're too big to go after alone. They require lots of different folks coming together from different disciplines. That's what the IIN does and does really well.
The opportunities to collaborate within the IIN is really the secret sauce. The science at IIN is like none other in the world. But what makes the IIN stand out is this amazing network of scientists and forward thinkers.
We're looking for people that define thought. The IIN has become a major hub of discoveries and inventions that are impacting people all over the world.
The IIN is one of the world's globally leading institutes in energy and sustainability. Researchers at IIN have developed the capability to produce what are known as mega libraries. These are millions of candidate materials that can be efficiently screened for sustainability and energy applications.
I work in a class of materials called metal organic framework. Another way of thinking about these materials as smart programmable sponges, we have the ability now to put our MOFs on the textile of uniforms to capture toxic chemicals and detoxify them instantaneously.
What we're seeing as a whole with nanotechnology and medicine is that nanotechnologies are really on the cutting edge of advancing care for our patients.
Spherical nucleic acids are kind of a hallmark invention of the IIN. Normal DNA will not enter cells freely. Spherical nucleic acids do. That allows you to move large therapeutic payloads into cells that allow you to treat a lot of very debilitating diseases.
IIN is working on a very exciting field of rational vaccinology.
The concept behind rational vaccinology is that you can take nanostructures and begin to put those components in different forms, and there will be a form that will give you much greater efficacy than all others.
In cancer therapies, it allows for us to develop a vaccine against a patient's cancer that's specifically targeted for that patient.
That is going to be a really, really powerful avenue of drug development, and one that I think is going to change medicine forever.
So you've got a structurally well-defined lead compound, and we can then systematically look at structure-function relationships.
It's on the way.
We have to make sure that we're not only doing cutting-edge research, but that we're beginning to train new generations of people that are going to have the skill set required to do this at the highest level and the passion to do this at our level.
I'm investigating developing a protein-based cancer vaccine. Being at the IIN, this is really the hub of where nanotechnology is. We have access to so many great faculty that are leaders in their own field. We're encouraged to come up with these new ideas that can really have a paradigm shift.
As scientists, being at the edge of science is what makes you get up every morning.
The future of the IIN is really quite bright. Everybody at the IIN is driven by the idea that nanoscience can make the world better.
It's that level of ambition, of wanting to make an impact, which has made IIN such a great research institute. IIN exemplifies the very best of Northwestern University.
We've created something that really is the envy of the world. We knew it was going to be big. We just didn't know it was going to be this big.